In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we come to worship the living God, let us call to mind our sins, but also call to mind God's never-failing mercy. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have gravely sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted of me. If in bed I say, 'When shall I arise?' then the nights drag on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The broken hearted. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast. For an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense. But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I became weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her by the hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, I have a confession to make. I'm tired. And so are you. We're all tired. It's called COVID fatigue. We are sick and tired of being sick and tired. And of all the readings that we can identify with, I think we identify most with the first reading, Job, who also was sick and tired of being sick and tired. Listen to the last words. "My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. And we said, thanks be to God, at the end of that. Think about that. I think our problem is that we are, like Job, are without hope. There is hope out there somewhere, but I don't think we have grasped it fully. We have become lukewarm in our hope, and we go through the motions of each day without really understanding what we need to do as Christians. We need to call upon the divine physician. And that's not to say that vaccines aren't good. The bishops have studied them and said that they are. And that is a bright light of hope. But what I'm talking about is our soul sickness, the lack of hope here. I think a lot of us have been placing our hope in the wrong things. The internet, Netflix, TV, the news. None of those are bringing us hope. None of those. And so we slowly evaporate and become transparent, wispy things that aren't really virile and full of life like God intended us to be. Like resurrected life makes us. We need to claim the hope that is in Jesus Christ. And if we're not doing it, we need to start it. My brothers and sisters, we are not praying hard enough. I know this. We let ourselves get anxious. We let ourselves get stressed. We let ourselves get depressed. God does not want those things. God wants healthy, happy children of God. We need to turn to the Lord, just as in the gospel, the mother-in-law of Peter did. We need to let him grasp us by the hand and pull us up. We need to be like all those sick people who gathered at the door and say to the Lord, Lord, I am hopeless. Help my hope. If we are having trouble being hopeful, and I think that is our main problem, we need to turn to the one who can help us. If we think that going out to a restaurant is going to cure our ills, we have another thing coming. If you think that going shopping is going to make everything normal again, think again. If you think that gathering together is going to be the panacea of everything, that is not. Those things will come in time, but that is not what we as Christians hope for. We hope in Jesus Christ, and we hope for the new life that he gives us. And if that new life is not being evidenced in our own lives, that means that we are failing. We need to get down on our knees every day and thank God that we, number one, are alive, and number two, that we belong to God, that he is looking out for us. COVID fatigue is a real thing. But even realer, or as I used to say to my college students, more-er realer-er, is Christ and the new life that he gives us. Let us put our hope in that. And when we are having trouble, Say the words, "Come, Holy Spirit." For the world does not need tired, sick, afraid Christians. If anything, right now, the world needs brave, well, happy Christians, so that we can pull our brothers and sisters out of COVID fatigue, not by our own means, but just like Jesus did with the help of the Holy Spirit, pulling Peter's mother-in-law back into life. The word that is used when she stands up in Greek is resurrection. She did not need to wait until the end of the world for her resurrection, and neither do we. We can claim our resurrected life right now. Brothers and sisters, let us earnestly turn toward the Lord. Let us be done with tiredness. Let us be done with anxiety. Let us turn to the Lord and ask for His help, for His life, that we might stir that little lukewarm ember into a flame again and be the Christians that the world needs right now. Together, let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us join together in prayer to the God of compassion, who heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
For our holy church, that as disciples of Jesus, we may respond selflessly and compassionately to those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead nations, may they respond with compassion and assistance to the needs of those who suffer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our church community who are suffering in any way, may they be transformed, healed, and restored by their faith in Christ Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who find it challenging to provide for themselves or their families due to unemployment, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those on our website's Vigil Light list and written in our Book of Prayer Intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may they be comforted and strengthened by God's word, especially Mike Gurley, Tom Rostrelli, Patrick Allen, Bill Spooner, Mike Kratzer, and Al Pappas. And for all who suffer from COVID-19, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have entered eternal life, especially for Anne Liberatore, Luz Williams, David Hansen, and for Elaine Pappas, whose one-year death anniversary we remember this week, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of healing and compassion, listen to the prayers of your people. Bring us closer to you this day, and may those who suffer find in you the comfort they seek. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. This time of the Mass is called the offertory. We offer not only the bread and wine, which will become the body and blood of Christ, but we also offer our hearts and our very lives, that they may be transformed. We also offer material goods, since this is when we usually take up a collection. If you would like to make an offering to support our ministry, we ask that you follow the promptings on the screen. Whether or not you are able to make a monetary offering at this time, may God bless you for the offering of your hearts and lives to his service. Pray, sisters and brothers, that this our sacrifice, yours and mine, may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Robert and John and Ramon our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the Lamb of God,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray to Saint Michael. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.